Greetings, this is Brad from the Cheese Shop. Well, it looks like we've made it to the very end here of the video series on creating a GURPS character. This is going to be a recap of what we've actually talked about in the past few videos. And I'm also going to, this is going to be more about the touchy-feely aspects of creating a character. So by this point, you've taken care of all the mechanical and technical aspects of the character, you know, spending all your points and, this part here is going to be about where you start in the process, different places you can start, and just different aspects of the character creation process. Like I said, just more of a touchy-feely aspect to it, not necessarily focusing on the rules. So when I talk about places to start on a character sheet, I don't start at the very beginning. I don't start with an attribute list and say I'm going to be really strong or I'm going to be dexterous or, you know, really smart. I actually start the majority of my characters in one of two places. The first I always pick are disadvantages. And what I do when I pick a disadvantage, I pick a disadvantage. So I pick one that's going to be the focus of my character. It's almost like my character's angst, you know, something that's just really difficult for them to overcome. And I want to take that and I want to make that what my character is striving to either overcome or deal with in their life. And then from there, I start thinking about what kinds of things would I do to actually overcome that. And my thought process continues on to something like skills. And I'll pick a few skills. I'll pick all of my skills. I'll just pick a few skills that help me deal with that disadvantage. And then I start thinking, okay, if he's got this, he or she's got this disadvantage, and I try to pick maybe an advantage. And then I always see attributes as advantages, not necessarily disadvantages, but I see them as advantages. So I include attributes in at that point. And once I have that basic part of my character, then I can decide what I want the concept to be. Now, you're probably saying, so, well, you picked a big disadvantage and it sounds like you've already got the concept of the character. When I mean the concept, I mean I want the character to be really different, but I also want this particular character to be able to fit in different types of characters. So I could actually pick some of the same advantages and disadvantages and skills and apply those to different types of characters, like maybe make a mage one time, or then the next time make some sort of space marine, or make some sort of noble, you know, back in the Middle Ages, or a swashbuckler or something like that, and still keep the same exact disadvantages and almost the same type of skills and the advantages, but the concept of the character is beyond that. So for me, my starting point on a character sheet almost always starts with a disadvantage, just one major disadvantage, and then I go from there. So it could be something like bloodlust. I'll take that and I'll say, okay, this is my character. This is what he's got to overcome, his bloodlust. Or I, you know, pick something else major. Usually my disadvantage that I pick is not going to be a -5 disadvantage points. It's going to be a disadvantage that's pretty substantial. And then, like I said, then I start working my character around that a little bit. And then I can come up with the character concept. Because to me, the character concept is complete whenever you understand the background of the character and how they're fitting into society, the time that you're going to be playing the adventure. Whatever that is, genre, time, place, it doesn't matter. So that's whenever I get to the character concept. And another thing about this is the reason why I do it like this is that this is a good place to start with your character. So if you're a player, new player, or seasoned veteran, doesn't matter. If you start with your character and you say, okay, I got a disadvantage, and I kind of got some skills that I want to use, and, you know, maybe a little bit of an advantage or attributes, not really having everything set in stone, you can contact the GM, which, like I said in all the other videos, you need to be doing anyway. You could contact the GM and say, hey, look, this is what I want to play. I got this guy or girl, and she's got this disadvantage, and I'm going to be trying to, you know, overcome this, or just, you know, just kind of give them some basics of it. And then they can say, you know, the GM can say, hey, that'll fit into the adventure. That'll definitely fit into the setting. Go with that. Or maybe you don't want to take that. That's probably not the direction that we're going with the adventure. But either way, you'll get some feedback. And then all you've spent on time was just looking in the book and picking a disadvantage and just, you know, looking at a few skills and writing them down on a piece of paper. I mean, you haven't even really filled out the character sheet yet. So if you have to go back, and you could take the, you know, the feedback you get back from the GM and go back to the character sheet or to your list and of stuff, and then just say, okay, this is what I need to make a change to, or that's good, and let's continue on. So this helps you create characters, and it actually helps in that you can make more characters. You can make all types of different characters, and I encourage that you do that. You don't have to have an adventure coming up that you can be playing in to make a character. I remember when I first started playing GURPS, I made, I can't tell you, I mean, I made so many characters. I mean, I wish I had all my old, you know, notebook pieces of paper and, you know, graph paper and all that stuff, because I had so many characters. I mean, I would love to use them now as NPCs and adventures, but that notwithstanding, you just need to make as many characters as you can make, whatever genres you feel comfortable, like, that you like. So if you read a ton of fantasy, or you read a bunch of science fiction or westerns, or just make those characters and start seeing how they can have a lot of similarities and be in any type of genre. That, and I can't tell you how that explains. That is the beauty of playing GURPS, is that when you can make a character one day that's, you know, a sheriff in the Old West, and take that exact same character, almost the exact same skills, the exact type, the concept, and then put that into Victorian times as some sort of law enforcement person. Or, you know, you could take that into space, or he can be some sort of superhero. Or you can make him a half-orc or some, you know, there's just so many things you can do with those, the concepts. You can just run them from so many different genres and times and places. So just be aware that when you make these characters, just if you make a bunch of them, you start getting better at it, and you start to see a pattern in how you make your characters, what's easiest for you as far as like where you start. But another thing that it helps you do is it helps you understand the rule system, and as far as character creation goes, and you also can get an idea of how it will play out in an adventure. So if you make a bunch of different mages, let's say you make five different mages, and you try to make them as different as possible, you can see how, and you decide to play one in an adventure, and you play a couple of adventures, you think, hey, this is great. You can go back to those other four mages and say, hey, how would this mage have handled the situation whenever we came up against, you know, some sort of MacGuffin, or, you know, some sort of adventure hook? How would that mage have handled that? Would that mage have done it differently because it has a different skill set, or it has a different set of disadvantages? You know, would it have run into danger instead of taking a cautious aspect and standing back? You know, there's a lot of different things, and see how that would play out and how that would have changed your story. And if you have all those characters made, you can start to see how, you know, you may like one aspect of one character and another aspect of another character, and you can start to make those into characters that you really enjoy playing, which in the long run makes role-playing easier, makes playing the character mechanically easier, and it also is a lot more fun. You know, you kind of get into your wheelhouse. Like sometimes people call them, you know, you get into your wheelhouse. Like it's just you play some of the same things, and that can be a good thing. But another thing is it just may not. That can hinder you sometimes, because it can keep you closed off to other things that you can actually try. So just make sure that you try making a lot of different characters, you know, and just download a PDF of the GURPS character sheet and just grab your pencil and just start writing a bunch of different, make up a bunch of different characters. Because in the long run, it will help you, and it'll give you some NPCs later if you decide to GM, which, you know, if you give that a shot, you can say, hey, I've got, you know, 30 characters to choose from for fighters or something like that. So just kind of go through that whenever you make your characters, and I think you'll have a lot more fun with that. There were a lot of different, there are many more rules in the character creation that we didn't cover in the videos, and there were things that I did omit. And most of it is because I didn't want to go too in-depth, but also I didn't want to go through the character creation and read off advantages and talk about them really in specifics, mainly because, one, that's the book there, and also that's not something that I don't think legally that you should be, that you're able to actually do. I mean, I'm not going to do something like that. So just be aware that when you buy the books, just read through if you're interested in a specific skill, advantage, or disadvantage. Like I had said before, just read through it and make sure you understand it. And if you don't understand it, just ask the GM or go onto the forums and ask people that have actually played those characters before and know more about it than you may actually know. There are a couple more things that are in the character creation process once you've finished and you've got almost everything set up. Is one of them is weapons and equipment. You know, you buy your armor, things like that. There's a section in the book that talks about equipment specifically. A lot of it's pretty self-explanatory. There's a lot more crunch and detail in there. You know, it's not just a matter of buying a sword and it does, you know, 1d plus 2 damage or, you know, of impaling damage or something like that. It's not just that. There's a lot of different things in there. It talks about reach and how much, you know, the weight, so if you're doing encumbrance. But just be aware that whenever you're talking with your GM, you know exactly what the expectations are with the equipment and what you can and can't buy. And then just go with that. You know, some GMs like to be very realistic and they get you down to the bullet or the, you know, the number of arrows that you have and how much they weigh and whether or not you can carry that. You know, do you have 6 weapons and how are you carrying those weapons? And then some GMs are just like, hey, you know, how much damage does it do? And how much does it cost? And how much does it weigh? You know, you can get down to just that basic. And so essentially you've got a caravan of junk on your back. So some GMs don't mind that. That's why it's always important to talk to the GM and find out exactly what they, what their expectations are. Now, I kind of wanted to talk about if when you're new to GURPS or like even if you've played before, something that has started that they've started to use are templates. And what these templates are, it's kind of a good, it's an amazing starting point actually. So let's say that you're really not completely familiar, you're still a little bit lost and you want to make some sort of thief, roguish type sort of character, or an assassin, or a mage, or a fighter, you can actually look at some of these templates in the characters book, and it'll say, like, I think mage is like 100 points, and it tells you how they got to that 100 points. It tells you what your strength is, your IQ, your health, your dexterity, it tells you all those things, and it'll say, in like advantages, it'll say like pick 2 of these 4 advantages. Because, I mean, a lot of people have preconceptions of what a fighter should be, what a mage should be, you know, different types of characters. So they kind of give you a little bit of flexibility in selecting. And it's really great if you're like, if, you know, one of your, you know, friends says, hey, you know, we're going to play. Can you make a character really quick? You're like, I really have no idea what I'm doing. And then they can say, well, here, let's just take this template real quick. Got to tweak it a little bit, and then we'll go from there. And then we can just jump right into the game. So there are some ways to actually get into the game without having to go through a character creation process. And if you've noticed the number of videos and how much I talk about different parts of it and how there's a lot of complexity to making a character, it can be very complex. And it can also be really simple. I mean, you can literally come to the game with your 3 6-sided dice, a piece of paper, and a pencil, and technically you can play the game. You can actually go in, get some of the basics, you know, throw down some attributes, advantages, disadvantages, pick some skills, buy your sword, and then just role play, just take off and go. And you can totally do that and have that, you know, type of character done in 5 or 10 minutes, or you could spend 2 or 3 days, or you could spend, you know, more realistically, probably an hour or two trying to go through. Once you become familiar with the system, this is what I want, those kind of things. So just be aware that the complexity of GURPS is really varied, and you can still have a ton of fun and be part of the game and do it very well just by making character within 5 to 10 minutes. Or, you know, like I said, you can take a couple hours to do it as well. So I hope everybody has enjoyed the videos on character creation. My main focus for doing this was that when I first came back into GURPS, I wanted to actually start seeing how much of, I mean, people actually still played it, and I found that it kind of, you know, lost its way in some respects on some places. You know, I was looking on the internet for videos and actual play videos or podcasts or something like that of GURPS games, and I just found that there weren't. I mean, it's just very slim. Some things were years ago, but they've either pod faded or, you know, just, you know, websites that are no longer working anymore. So I did want to give this to, I mean, I don't expect veterans to watch these videos and go, you know, hey, I learned a ton. My hope is that someone that hasn't played the game before and, you know, is just, you know, knows a little bit about it, you know, has heard of it, can go through the videos and say, hey, this is probably something that I could do, and it's pretty cool, and I really want to start to play. I mean, if I can just, you know, if just three people, or you know, if one person does it, if one person watches the videos and says, hey, I'm going to go get the book or get GURPS Lite, you know, and I'm going to start, or I'm going to go actively look for somebody that actually plays GURPS and see if I can get into a game or something like that, then to me, that's all worthwhile. I mean, I just wanted to share. I mean, I've been sharing on my blog with writing. System specific. I mean, there is some, there's a majority of it is GURPS related, but there's also some just neutral stuff, system neutral topics in there as well. And if the videos become popular, which I have no clue whether or not they will, I don't know. I don't necessarily like watching myself talk on a video, but if they do get popular, then maybe I'll start picking out different concepts to talk about within the GURPS system. I'd like to do reviews of the different books, and I'd also like to see how this progresses. And I hope it goes well. So I really thank everybody for watching these videos. And if you started with this video, that's cool. You can always go back and see the others. And I hope everyone enjoys playing GURPS as much as I do. So if you have any questions or comments, by all means, post them here on YouTube, or you can go to my website, thecheeseshop.org. It's a blog, and post comments there. I'm actually pretty much everywhere on the internet, so you can't find me. You can find me pretty much everywhere, and I link a lot of different accounts to a lot of different places. And if you have any questions about GURPS, you can ask me, or, you know, if you want to, you can go to the GURPS forums, or, you know, go to Steve Jackson Games website, there's going to be a link down at the bottom. And I hope to see everyone at a table at one time or another playing role-playing games. I feel that that's something that's amazing and should be cherished. Bye.